grace God, fills me, God.
Morning. I think we lost one, didn't we?
Oh, where did he go?
Aria.
Aria.
Come on. Come on. I'm going to have my work cut out for me this week on Thursdays. Okay. What I would like to do is read a little scripture first from John 20. It was early in the morning on the first day of the week, while it was still dark. Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone was moved away from the entrance. She ran at once to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, breathlessly panting. They took the master from the tomb. We don't know where they put him. Peter and the other disciple left immediately for the tomb. They ran neck and neck. The other disciple got to the tomb first, outrunning Peter. Stooping to look in, he saw the pieces of linen cloth lying there, but he didn't go in. Simon Peter arrived after him, entered the tomb, observed the linen cloth lying there, and the kerchief used to cover his head, not lying with the linen cloth, but separate, neatly folded by itself. Why did Jesus fold the napkin? Here it is. Back in Jesus' time, there was Hebrew tradition about meals between the master and the servant. When the servant would put the meal out for the master, he would put it all out, you know, set it all up, put the napkin there by the plate or wherever they were eating, and then the servant would kind of step out to the side and wait for the master to be finished. So there was the way that the servant knew that the master was done with the meal. The napkin, you know, wet it up and put on the table. So that way the servant knew to come and take all the stuff away. Well, if the master was not finished, he just wanted to take a break, then he would fold the napkin. And he would put the folded napkin on the table. That way the servant knew not to clear anything away. So, that's what Jesus is telling us, is when he folded the napkin in the tomb and laid it there, he meant he's coming back. So, praise God that he's coming back for us. Okay? Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you so much that this something as simple as a napkin lying in a tomb gives us such joy and promise that you will be coming again. Amen.